Huff spots other red flags.
The plate on the car was pretty much brand new, and it was very clean. There was not very much in the car. Adding things up in my head, it didn't add up. Abro puerta, señor.
Officers escort the driver into the station and pull the sedan into secondary inspection.
This mirror right here, there's Bondo. Bondo dust all over the mirror. That's not normal.
Auto body fillers like Bondo or new bolts suggest possible tampering.
Just looking for shiny screws and to see if you have another access point besides there. It's right there, huh?
You can see the packages right there.
There you go.
Within minutes, officers uncover a hidden compartment in the center console.
There's more, right?
There's more. Oh, yeah. Definitely more.
We're going to have to rip this one apart.
This is typical, especially on this any sedan or SUV or anything that's got a lot of length to it. They can use this because there's normally a space like this.
Just rip it apart.
Open sesame.
Only six bundles are pulled out.
Yeah, that's it. There's one more.
Nope. To waste a vehicle on just a couple of pounds.
Huff and his team suspect there may be another stash. Now they face an exhausting task: rip apart every inch of the car.
There's another compartment.
More here, look, the racco panels.
CBP officer Huff and his team have hit on a second narcotics load in the back.
Rocker's got them too?
Yep.
Right underneath here. Right in this spot right here.
Hey, you know what? I'm pulling this stuff out. I'm gonna get rid of this carpet. So
I can get a good place.
Here it is. Right in here. Another package. See, this is a package right here. That's not natural. They might have just loaded everything in this car. Well, we kept thinking that just having it in the console there seemed like a waste. Finding all the rest, it makes more sense. Oh, that Bondo, man. We've got a non-factory compartment built up back here. We can see and smell Bondo.
This is fresh.
See this? This is all extra. They used gold paint to try to match it in, but somehow they ran out because they left some of it gray.
And you can hear as you hit this side. Will you hear this?
There's a difference in the sound resonance. Yeah. Go for it, dude.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. There's more. See it? Check this angle over here. Over here. That'll do it. All through here.
It's more, dude.
The cavity under the back seat
in here
offers smugglers plenty of space to stash their drugs.
The whole thing is loaded from side to side.
It's like every little chasm that they could load in this car, they did.
Do it. Do it.
There we go.
Open. Why we use the big stick.
It's a lot of more narcotics inside the underneath the seat.
Well, when we pull cars apart, we pull them apart any way we can see fit.
I think for me, that's the best part of the job here.
That's the best part of catching a load, tearing up cars apart.
We'll tally up what we've got here and take it inside.
I'm putting the narcotics in the narco pouch to do a field test. That way we could determine what kind of narcotics we've encountered today. There it is. It's color purple. Purple tells us that narcotics were positive for marijuana.
The total, 35 pounds, worth $35,000 on U.S. streets. The bust is less than 1% of the marijuana confiscated in Arizona in a single day.
Not a lot of ports have the action that we do down here.
But for officers, every seizure keeps the job exciting.
One of the perks, you get to find drugs.